In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. So as we gather for Mass this morning, we remember particularly the soul of Ursula Derry, who died this time last year during those terrible times of COVID. But now we have a chance to celebrate her life and celebrate properly her funeral Mass. So let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Ursula, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. And now we will all be seated, and we listen to the word of God in the readings proclaimed by Martina and Sean.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a reason, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck out what is planted. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sew. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time for war and a time for peace. God has made everything suitable for its time. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Goodness restores. reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When our earthly life is over, God has an everlasting house built for us in heaven. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. So we are always confident, even though we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we do have confidence, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are away, home or away, we make it our aim to please him. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I will return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. And now you may be seated for a few moments. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. On Christmas night, after celebrating two masses in St. Patrick's, I went home to the Moy Road and watched Archbishop Eamon Martin celebrate Christmas Mass from St. James's Church in Grange, County Louth, not far outside of Carlingford. It is one of the oldest Christian sites in Ireland. Mass has been celebrated on that site for over 1,000 years. Now, Ursula, Derry would have known it well, as she was from a neighboring townland called Galtrum Island. And Father Michael O'Dwyer is from Crossalene, another neighboring townland. And shortly after Ursula died, I happened to meet Father Michael, and he said, "I see you buried Mrs. Derry." He explained that when he first saw her in this church, he mistook her for her twin sister, Bernadette, whom he would have known from home. They were Murphys. So small world indeed. And Grange was known for centuries as an official part of the Camino, a departure point for pilgrims on their way to Compostela in northern Spain, to the shrine of St. James. So both churches are dedicated to the same St. James. And Greenore would have been the point of departure. Greenore always seems to reinvent itself. In her youth, Ursula, along with her sister Bernadette, would have worked in the hotel there, which was a busy place, an important landmark built by the Great Northern Railway, which flourished as long as the railway line was open. Of course, more recently, Greenore has become well known as a busy deep water port for container vessels. Ursula came from a large family of 14 children who would have seen in their turn Carlingford, Greenore, and O'Meath all have their heydays. And later she went on to work in P.J. Carroll's in Dundalk for a good number of years. How she never smoked nor drank is a mystery, as staff in P.J. Carroll's used to receive an allowance of cigarettes in their wages when it was still politically correct to do so. All of us are travellers. We're all pilgrims on this earth. And while we are on a common journey, each one's journey is unique. For those like Ursula who have faith, it is a journey to the other world, the promised land of heaven. It is Christ who reveals to us the true nature of that promised land, the true goal of our earthly journey. Heaven is not a place, but a special relationship with God. God is our final destination. The spiritual journey began at baptism. In baptism, our life was linked to that of Christ. At baptism, we join God's people, to people with faith, like Ursula. That means we no longer travel alone. On that journey, in a dance hall, Ursula met her husband, Aloysius. They married and set up home in Killycommaine. Ursula laid down one condition. Ali had to bring her back home to visit Bernadette and the rest of the Murphy clan every weekend. And so it was for almost 46 years. After Pauline, Teresa, and twins John and Jackie were born, they moved then to Garvaghy Park, where Martina and Monica then were born. Plenty of children, not a dull moment. Ursula loved watching horse racing and liked to play bingo, which she said was a way to exercise her brain and socialize in a healthy way. Well, I wouldn't be too sure of that one. She wouldn't have needed any cigarettes from P.J. Carroll's with the smoke in the bingo halls in those days. I mentioned Ursula's faith. She visited the chapel twice a day and would often promise people, "I'll say a prayer for you." The children were invited to say the rosary every night. Ursula liked to walk and would always dress up in a suit with her makeup and her lipstick, even if it was just to go up the town. Sadly, Ursula was diagnosed with Alzheimer's and vascular dementia in 2008. Then in 2013, she started to live in the care home. She still liked to travel, especially going back to Carlingford. And she loved the trips that were arranged for the residents, going to coffee shops where she could watch the world go by, back to Boots to chat the ladies at the makeup counter, to Peter Marks to get the hair done, and then to visit the chapel. It was Ollie's anniversary yesterday. He died in 2006, and tomorrow would be Ursula's first anniversary. As we all move on our pilgrim way, let Ursula's own words give us courage. I light a candle and say a prayer for you. I extend my sympathy and that of Canon Toner to Pauline, Teresa, John, Jackie, Martina and Monica, to Adrian, Gary, Carol, Noel and Sean, the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren, and all the family. And may she rest in peace. The prayers of the faithful, they will be proclaimed to us by Melissa, Neve, Nicole, and Martina. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, our Granny Ursula received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Our Granny Derry is nursed at the table of the Saviour. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our Granny Derry. Strengthen our hope so that we may live on the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Family and friends of our dear mother, seek comfort and consolation. Heal our pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all the vulnerable and those with dementia in our society. May they be kept safe. May they be protected. Lead a dignified, happy and comfortable life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember all those who lost their lives during the pandemic. We remember all the families suffering and all those who are still with us. Those who are alone, isolated, and separated from their loved ones. May humanity be restored and preserved, and compassionate care be delivered to all of us. May there be a return to normalised visiting. Sorry, I meant safe and meaningful visiting and care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. And we remember all whose anniversaries are today. Catherine Watkins and baby Eva Boland. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and praise the Lord's name for the good of all the
Holy
Church.
As we humbly present you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Ursula, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful Judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Oh, indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and when entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Damon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Ursula, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And as we usually do for the distribution of Holy Communion, I will begin by distributing those on my right hand middle aisle here. And the Minister of the Eucharist will start over here at the Stations of the Cross side. When she has finished distributing there, then I will move over and distribute to those on my left hand middle aisle, while the Minister then goes over to the choir side. So we just take our time and keep safe.
It's not my
And just before Martina gives us a little reflection, the same beautiful reflection that's on her mum's memorial card, I want to say an act of spiritual communion for those who, for whatever reason, be it travel, be it COVID, be it whatever, that are not able to be with us this morning, but who would like to, and maybe tuning in at home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
God saw you getting tired, and a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around you and whispered, "Come to me." With tearful eyes, we watched you as you slowly slipped away. And though we loved you dearly, we couldn't make you stay. Your golden heart stopped beating. Your tired hands put to rest. God broke our hearts to prove to us he only takes the best. Rest in peace, Mummy.
Thank you, Martina. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Ursula may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And just before the blessing, I would like to, on behalf of the family, offer thanks to everyone who cared for Ursula, everyone whose kind expression of sympathy and support were given throughout the last year, all who have attended today, and all helpers, both here in the church and the musicians, which was beautiful, and everybody else who have travelled to be here today. And I would just add to that, a safe home, and please, as you leave the church, just to remember what's still in our midst and try to avoid too much close contact. And we pray that that will be lifted from us, hopefully, in the coming year. If ever there was a New Year wish that everybody would like to be fulfilled, it would be that. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and stay safe.